In the previous video, we created this page which displays a YouTube video in elements that we've added to ourselves. If you've ever made a web page before, you'll know that there are many different ways to lay out a web page, but most web pages typically have four sections. They will have a name of the website at the top left, and then maybe some options across the top. On the left, they will have a couple of options which outline which pages are available. And then in the main content area on the bottom right, you'll have all of the actual content of that page. Rather than being prescriptive about how you go about making your web pages, Polymer just gives you the elements so that you can decide how to lay your pages out yourself. If you look at the code for the page that we created in the previous video, we can see that we used the paper header panel to actually lay out our page. And this is what gave us the header panel across the top once we added it, as well as the actual contents below that header panel. So how do we go about creating a section on the left of the page which is going to contain the name of the website, as well as a list of menu options? Well as the paper header panel, Polymer also provides us with a panel called paper draw panel, which we can import now. And we're actually going to wrap the entirety of our current web page within this panel. Now this in itself isn't going to do much for us, because this is going to be the content still, and it's all going to be displayed within the page. And if we refresh the page, we can see that it's all going to disappear, because we haven't actually specified how we want it to be displayed. But what you can see is the fact that we do have this section on the left, as well as a section on the right. So we now need to go ahead and split this into two sections vertically. To do that, we're going to actually import a header panel again. So I'm just going to duplicate this. And because we've already imported the header panel, we're not going to need to import it the second time we're going to use it. And we're just going to copy this across. Again, because we're going to import the toolbar here, we don't need to import it again later on. So we can delete that line as well. And we're going to keep our name the same. Now if we were to refresh this page again, we would still actually not have any content displayed, because we haven't actually specified how we want to use this header panel. And so we need to add a custom property to it, which is simply draw. And with this second header panel, we also need to add another property to it, which is simply main. So if we go back to the page and refresh again, we can see that we are making some progress. We have our new header displaying in the top left, and this is the area where we're going to have our menu. And we also have the actual contents of the page displaying on the right. So let's go ahead and add that menu in. Now because this is going to be within the draw section, it's simply going to be a matter of importing the paper menu element. So we'll copy the import line across. And we'll also create that paper menu. And within that menu, we're also going to want some paper items. And so if we duplicate this section and rename this to paper item. And this needs to be renamed to paper toolbar, or rather to paper menu. And we'll just create a couple of these options just to see that it's working properly. So if we refresh our page again, we'll be able to see that we have our menu items available to us now, and they've already been stylized according to the Polymer styles. And we can also tidy up the contents section. So for example, we don't want the same title to appear twice. We want this to be the name of the section that we're actually looking at. And we also don't want this white part to be hidden now. So to change the name, it's obviously just a matter of changing the name here. And we can obviously use the same title as we had earlier. And to make the main element stand out from the main page, we can also move this below the toolbar again. So if we refresh the page again, we can see that we have all of the correct styles. For example, this header does have a drop shadow. And of course, if we wanted to, we could continue to edit the styles to suit our exact needs. Now you may be wondering why it's useful to actually have a draw section separate to the main content itself. Well, if we press F12, we'll see that we get the developer console, which is an easy way to test out different sizes. So you can simply drag the development console out and you can see that the page is changing size. As soon as we drop below a certain size, the actual draw is going to disappear automatically for us, because the Polymer elements themselves are built with responsive design in mind. And we can also use the developer console to see how the page will be displayed on certain devices by clicking on this phone icon here. And as you can see, by default, the draw panel on the left is hidden. Now if you're going to want to take your website into a production environment, you're obviously going to want to style the website to suit your company's style guides. Not all companies, for example, have blue as their company colour. They may want to change the background colour to something else, etc, etc. In the next video, we're going to cover how to go about customising the elements, both on an individual level and also in a more generic cross-site method. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss that.